I'm going to be making a lower carb version of my beef stew in the electric pressure cooker. First step is to set your pressure cooker to 30 minutes and hit the start button. And what this does is it heats up the pressure cooker and allows you to brown the meat a little bit, which will add a little bit of extra flavor to your beef stew. Once the pressure cooker is heated up just a little bit, go ahead and add a little bit of olive oil to the bottom of the pot. Next, add your meat into the pressure cooker. I'm using 2 packages of stew meat that I got on clearance at Target. But the great thing about this recipe is you can use as much or as little as you like. Then just spread that around so as much of the meat is touching the pan as possible to get that browning process started. Next, I'm going to add 1 medium white onion that I have chopped up. You can add a red onion, you can add whatever you have. Next, I'm adding 2 ribs of chopped celery and about 1 cup of baby carrots. You can leave those out if you're going super low carb. I'm just gonna give this a quick stir before I add the rest of the ingredients. I'm adding in 1 teaspoon of black pepper, but you can add more or less depending on what your family likes. 3 cloves of crushed garlic, 2 bay leaves, 1 teaspoon of sage, and 3 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. Next, I'm adding in 1 can of diced tomatoes. I prefer the fire roasted, but you know, use whatever you have. And 1 32-ounce box of beef broth. Just give it a quick stir. And once it's done, I'm going to be adding in some frozen broccoli and frozen riced cauliflower. You just close the lid and seal the exhaust valve. Once the timer goes off, do a quick release of the steam. If all of the steam has been released, it's safe to open your pressure cooker. And this is what it looks like. It's pretty amazing. Now add in your frozen riced cauliflower and your frozen broccoli. Stir it up a little bit and close the lid. Leave it closed for probably 5 to 10 minutes, however long it takes to get the broccoli and cauliflower cooked to your liking. And here is what the finished product looks like. This stuff is so delicious. It's so good. It's a little bit thinner than your regular beef stew because we didn't add any flour to it to thicken it up, but it has the same flavor. And like I said, it's delicious. So if you like this recipe, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to hit that little bell right next to the subscribe button so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and Facebook at LeighsHome05. Thanks for watching. Bye.